This executive order, signed by President Trump, starts a new policy on refugees and immigration in America.
And this is the protection of the nation from foreign terrorist entry into the United States.
But that's not what's really in this executive order. So let's go through it. First, the order bans all immigrants and visa holders from 7 majority Muslim countries from entering the U.S. for at least 90 days. There is no security benefit. Americans are more likely to be killed by their own clothes than by an immigrant terrorist. Nobody in the U.S. has been killed in a terrorist attack by immigrants from these particular 7 nations. But the U.S. is now treating everybody from these countries as if they are a suspect. Computational biologist Samira Asghari said she now can't come here to work on immunogenomics at Harvard. Oscar winner Asghar Farhadi can't come back to the U.S. for the Oscars, where he's nominated again. Sudanese Dr. Suha Abu Shama hurried back to the U.S. to begin work at the prestigious Cleveland Clinic, only to be put back onto a plane out hours later. But in addition to these travel bans, the executive order also begins a fundamental shift in American refugee policy. The order halts nearly all refugee admissions for 120 days and admissions of Syrian refugees indefinitely. And it says in the future, refugees will only be admitted from countries that have sufficient safeguards in place to ensure the security and welfare of the United States. This is the opposite of how the U.S. has defined refugees in the past. People fleeing persecution and violence that their own governments cannot or will not protect them from. And this comes at a time when the world faces its biggest refugee crisis since World War II. 1 in 122 people worldwide are displaced. And those fleeing the largest humanitarian emergency of our time, the Syrian Civil War, are the ones singled out by Trump for harsher restrictions. If you're worried about U.S. terrorist attacks like 9/11, San Bernardino, or the Orlando Pulse shooting, this order would have prevented exactly none of them. But there is an exception for some kinds of refugees.
As it relates to persecuted Christians, do you see them as kind of a priority here?
Yes, you do. Yes, they've been horribly treated.
The U.S. will allow members of religious minorities in the individual's country of nationality during the 120-day ban and prioritize them thereafter.
You know, if you were a Christian in Syria, it was impossible, very, very tough to get into the United States. If you were a Muslim, you could come in. But if you were a Christian, it was almost impossible.
In fact, half of refugees in the past 2 years were Christian. Refugees from Syria reflected the country's religious composition, almost entirely Muslim. But all this aligns with Trump's anti-Muslim promises throughout the campaign.
Donald J. Trump is calling for a total and complete shutdown of Muslims entering the United States.
Trump spoke about taking an America First approach at his inauguration.
From this day forward, it's going to be only America First. America First.
This executive order shows how much that vision aligns with the original America First movement. That movement sought American isolationism too. They were against American intervention in World War II. That attitude resulted in the infamous decision in June 1939 to turn away the St. Louis. That ship had 937 Jewish refugees aboard, fleeing another hostile government, Hitler's. First, they were turned away in Cuba.
The liner St. Louis turned back from Cuba.
Then they approached Florida, but the U.S. Coast Guard patrolling the waters kept them away too. They eventually disembarked in Belgium, the Netherlands, and France.
Jewish unfortunates without a country permitted to land in Belgium after 5 weeks of suspense afloat.
And eventually hundreds died in the Holocaust. Since then, the U.S. government has been the world's leader in resettling refugees.
They finally reach a haven of safety.
The State Department website still brags about it, claiming 3 million refugees resettled around all 50 states since 1975. And the Statue of Liberty bears these goals, too. A plaque on the side of the pedestal reads, "Give me your tired, your poor, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free, the wretched refuse of your teeming shore. Send these, the homeless, tempest-tossed to me. I lift my lamp beside the golden door." America hasn't always lived up to these lofty goals. But since World War II, we've lived in an era where the diversity of who gets to come to the United States has gone up and up. A federal judge stayed deportation of those stuck in airports amidst the confusion. and the Trump administration has already started scaling back.
As far as green card holders moving forward, it doesn't affect them.
But the Trump administration is trying to end the era when America didn't care what religion you are, regardless of where you come from. Legal challenges and protests around the country continue to try to preserve it.